And OPEC reached a historic deal to slash oil production across the world in order to potentially stabilize the market. And it's hitting Oklahoma especially hard with price and demand down. Two Works for You's Aaron Conrad talks with a local expert about the deal and what this could mean for our state.
Here in Oklahoma, we have 5% of the U.S. crude oil reserves. And just last year in 2019, we were the fourth largest oil producing state in the country. Coronavirus and an oil price war impacting jobs here in our state.
Companies like Halliburton already closing their Duncan office, laying off 350 people. Word of impending layoffs at other Oklahoma oil and gas companies continue. Our state already overloaded with unemployment claims from all industries. Tom Sang is the director of TU's School of Energy Economics, Policy, and Commerce. He says the historic deal to cut nearly 10 million barrels of oil may not be enough to stop the downward spiral.
Look at the grand scheme of things. There's estimates that we've probably lost minimally 20 million barrels a day of demand. And there's some projections that by the end of this month, we will have lost 30 million barrels of demand globally. So you look at it and go, wow, a 10 million barrel cut is huge, except that, you know, not when you've already lost potentially 30 million of demand.
Sang says we may not see things improve until the summer when people start going back to work and traveling again. As for how this OPEC deal will impact the economy, his verdict, wait and see. Aaron Conrad, Two Works for You.